We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman, issue 86. This is from the Rebirth series, I think it was 2016, written by James Tynion IV. Tony Daniels did the pencils, Danny Meekie inks, Tommy Mori colors, Clayton Cowles letters, Tony Daniels and Tommy Mori did the cover. I like that cover. It's really dynamic and cool looking. Doesn't tell you anything about what's going on in the book though, but it is a really nice cover picture. Dave Walgo's associate editor, Ben Abernathy and Jamie S. Rich co-editors. Okay, so this is the first post-Tom King book, so I thought I'd give it a chance, see where it goes. Turns out there's something big going down in Gotham. There's a group of five people aiming to do some kind of damage. Bruce Wayne is trying to use the Wayne Foundation to rebuild parts of Gotham City and improve the city, and he's gotten a lot of stuff going. A lot of stuff got through. He was able to use his influence to make the city expand and do better. But Deathstroke has other ideas, and Batman has to deal with that. He's trying out a new machine called the Night Climber. Kind of cool looking. Well, he's got Catwoman working inside Wayne Industries or Foundation or whatever to try and stop another aspect of their plan. So the only problems I really saw in here were the way that Selina's drawn looks a little weird sometimes. Her body proportions look odd. I don't know why they look odd to me, but they do. Like, her head looks like an odd shape considering her neck and the length of her arms. I don't know if that's just the outfit or the way she's drawn, but there's a couple of scenes where it just doesn't match up. But Batman looks great. Deathstroke looks really cool. A lot of others look really good. It's a bit of a rushed issue in many respects because a lot of the fighting is taken out, which kind of disappoints me. I like the action element, but the story was pretty good. It's a lead into something else going on. There is a section here where Bruce has a bit of a human moment where he accidentally calls Lucius Fox Alfred, and if you've been reading the books, you know that they killed off Alfred recently, and I look forward to them bringing him back because anything Tom King did to Batman needs to be undone because it's awful and he's a terrible writer. So I think they need to undo that. But overall, this was a really good issue. It was really solid, really interesting story. It's a part one, but I'm intrigued to see where it goes. I thought the art, aside from Selina, was pretty consistently good, and the perspective shots were good. The fight scenes, what little of them there were good. And I really like that cover image. That would make a cool poster. So this is a recommend. I'm glad I can finally recommend the regular Batman book again, now that weirdo Tom King's off the book. Definitely check it out if you get a chance. I think it was a lot of fun, and I'm looking forward to the next issue. But that's just my opinion. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the About page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman, issue 87. This is from the 2016 series. This issue was written by James Tynion IV, with Guillaume March artist, Tomu Mori colors, Clayton Cowles letters, Tony Daniels and Tomu Mori cover. Dave Walgos was associate editor, Ben Abernathy editor. The cover's pretty cool, but that kinda doesn't happen here, but it is very dynamic and will get you to buy the book. Now, this is the second issue that is after the Tom King run, so I was a little hesitant to pick this up. This is part two of their Dark Designs, and honestly, it does do a pretty good job of bringing you up to speed. The art is a little surrealist. It's sort of a mix between Tony Daniels and Kelly Jones, which is really weird to say, but Penguin looks really gross and surreal, and Riddler looks really weird, but they're having an interesting conversation around what's going on, but not directly saying what's going on. Sort of like people in the know that don't want to talk about something have a conversation about that thing. So they've made some kind of deal with somebody called the Designer. That's who they call him anyway, and it means there is some kind of plan in play. Meanwhile, Batman took the five assassins that he captured to Gotham headquarters, but the GCPD probably can't hold these people despite the cool new cells that Wayne Enterprises gave them. Meanwhile, one of these criminals is actually escaped, and it's Cheshire, and we get to see Batman try and apprehend her. This was an action-packed book. Stuff happened, plot advanced. It's a decent standalone because you do get to see Batman going after Cheshire. At the same time, the subplots are developing with what these other assassins are and what's going on with Riddler and Penguin. I was amazed. This was a lot of fun. I was shocked to see how good Batman can be when in the hands of a decent writer and out of the hands of Tom King's hideous meddling. So this was a fantastic book. I enjoyed it quite a bit. I would definitely recommend this and say if you get the chance to go out and pick this up, do it. If you're a Batman fan, I think you'll enjoy this. There's a little bit of Groflex, which I find annoying. If you can't use the actual swear word, just don't use it. Don't substitute it with the stupid symbols. It's lazy writing. Other than that one minor complaint, this was definitely a solid issue. The art is really good. The artist really has a good handle on how to draw Batman, and I was real happy to see that. So Batman looks really awesome through the whole thing. He acts like Batman. You know, he's out doing his solving puzzles and crimes and apprehending bad guys. Good times all around. Good peril, good adventure, good story. So this is a definite recommend. I am absolutely looking forward to the next issue. But that's just my take. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Batman, issue 88. This is from the 2016 series, and this is part 3 of Their Dark Designs, written by James Tynion IV, art by Guillaume March. Tomi Mori did colors, Clayton Cowles letters, Tony S. Daniel, and Tomi Mori did the cover. That cover is awesome. That's how covers should look. Dynamic, action-packed, gets you to buy the issue. That's a fantastic cover. I like that. That should definitely be a poster. Dave Walgos was the associate editor, Ben Abernathy editor. While Batman is trying to deal with Cheshire, he needs a car fast. Thankfully, Lucius gave him a really cool new tool. They explain it really well. Meanwhile, Catwoman is digging up a grave of somebody, wow, really surprising. And we learn how the bad guys escaped the Gotham PD, and that is explained really well in here. And it's not just some stupid MacGuffin, it's actually pretty interesting. Well, Batman shows up and things go really, really crazy. And he has to make a really rash choice, but he makes the moral decision and actually gains a lot of information out of it. And we get an unexpected guest appearance at the end of the issue. This was a solid issue all around. Great action, great storytelling. Batman's got his testosterone back, finally, and it was just awesome. This was nonstop motion, things progressing, storytelling was fantastic. The art really came together quite well. I don't think I had any real complaints about the art. The panels were dynamic. There's some great action scenes in here. It was a fantastic issue. The only downside is a stupid preview for Amethyst at the end with some really garbage art. That looks really stupid. But all in all, this Batman issue is phenomenal. I highly recommend it. If you just find this issue and you can't find the first two parts of this, issues 86 and 87, you can jump in here pretty well, and I think you'll be caught up enough to have a pretty good understanding of what's going on. The minor details like who the designer is, we still don't know, so you'll be able to kind of piece together most of what's going on and enjoy it just for the action elements and what's going on with Catwoman's storyline. So if you get a chance, I would definitely recommend this. If you can get issues 86, 87, and this one, and try and get the whole storyline because they are phenomenal. Don't go before 85 because those are all trash. But this is a real Batman book. Highly, highly recommended. That, however, is just my opinion. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon and Streamlabs and other links are in the description and on the About page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman, issue 89. This is from the Rebirth line, written by James Tynion IV, Carlos Pagulian, Guillermo March, and Danny Meekie were the artists. Tomi Mori did the colors, Clayton Cowles letters, Tony S. Daniel and Tomi Mori did the cover. Cover's okay, kind of boring. Dave Walgo's associate editor, Ben Abernathy editor. Alright, Batman is on the hunt for whoever is causing all these problems and hired captured the assassins. Penguin is in the hospital, barely, while Batman takes out Gunsmith, and Catwoman and Harley are at the grave of somebody that we thought was the Joker, but we get an explanation as to who that really is when they are ambushed by Merlin. Meanwhile, Batman has to take on a guy known as Mr. Teeth, who was called the Tooth Eater when he was doing some serial killings out in Portland, and that guy's over at Riddler's place. So once Batman has to deal with that, he finally gets a look at the designer's costume, and he has to try and figure out what's going on. He does meet up with some of the others, and we've got a cliffhanger ending. This was a really solid issue. A lot happens, and it looks like Catwoman is going to confess some secrets to Batman next issue, and we did get a glimpse at a new sidekick for the Joker, but she isn't really revealed until Hell Arisen issue 3, and then she's named in that issue too. But this is technically her first appearance, I suppose, but she's not named, and it's mostly in cameo. We only get two vague images, so I'm not really counting that one. But it's a solid issue, and I would definitely recommend it. The art is solid. The storyline is pretty good so far. There's a lot of action in this one, as well as plot development, but the development of the plot is actually pretty interesting, so we're seeing a lot going on. There is quite a bit of talking, but it is all pushing the plot forward. It's not a bunch of frivolous nonsense, so I'm really liking what I'm seeing so far. So I'm definitely going to recommend this. I thought it was a fun read, and it's a good addition to the Batman story, and it's way better than what Tom King was doing. But that's just my take on it. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description, and as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Batman issue 90. This is from the Rebirth line of 2016. This is part 5 of Their Dark Designs, written by James Tynion IV, Jorge Jimenez artist, Tomi Mori colors, Clayton Cowles letters. Jimenez and Mori did the cover, which the cover's okay. It's a cool pinup, but it tells you nothing really about any action or anything. Get used to that one. So it's a pretty accurate cover. Editor was Ben Abernathy, associate editor Dave Weigels. Harley Quinn is flying bat drones at Deathstroke because for some reason. Meanwhile, Batman and Selina have a very, very long conversation. Like, it takes up a lot of this issue. And we get some flashback story, which is actually pretty cool. The classic rogues gallery is brought together. We've got Catwoman, Riddler, Joker, and Penguin brought to this place called Tartarus House, and it's kind of hidden out in the harbor, and that's where the designer lives. The designer is this legendary master criminal who's got this amazing reputation. Real hush-hush type stuff. The sort of thing, he's like a boogeyman for super criminals, and he invites them to this house to help them become better crooks. Each person is taken into this office area and discusses, like, their greatest plan ever and how they could do it. He's gonna help them pull it off, kind of to take them to their next level of mastery, because they're thinking too small. So he seems to be trying to mentor them in a way. It's a little bit convoluted, but you get the general idea. Well, the designer has Catwoman come up with a master plan, and then after a few hours, it's Cobblepot's turn, and then Enigma's, and finally the Joker's. And then when the Joker is in there with the designer, he says something that irritates the designer to the point where he's ready to kill these people. Well, things go horribly wrong, and they think the designer is dead. So they burn the house down, and they take off. Well, the plan Catwoman came up with involves Batman, and that's not good. So we're left with a cliffhanger ending. It's not quite as good as the cliffhanger ending from last issue, but it ties in, and it's very frightening for the Bat family. So this is really building up to an interesting story arc. Unfortunately, this issue is massively boring. It takes a long time to get to the point when this really could have been a little more action-packed. The whole thing with Catwoman and Batman's interaction is, it's incredibly boring, and it's that sort of mushy, lazy TV writing romance type of writing. It really harkens back to Tom King's Batman, where Batman lacks testosterone and needs to lean on Catwoman way too much in a very unhealthy relationship kind of way. So I was a little disappointed with that. It's not the worst thing I've ever read. It's decent middle story if you're reading this in the trade paperback, but as a single issue, it really didn't work for me. So I'm hesitant to recommend this one. I'd say pick it up out of the back issue bin or wait till the trade. Hopefully the rest of it picks up, but so far this is definitely the weakest one of the post-Tom King runs. I'm not giving up up on the series just yet. We'll see how it goes. But until then, this is by far the weakest issue so far. But that's just my take. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman issue 91. This is from the 2016 Rebirth series. This issue is written by James Tynion IV with Rafael Albuquerque, Jorge Jimenez, and Carlo Pangulian and Danny Meekie as the artists. That's a lot of people for art, DC. Tomi Mori did the colors, Clayton Cowles letters, cover by Jimenez and Mori. Associate editor was Dave Walgos, Ben Abernathy was the editor. Cover's good, I think it's pretty solid, but that scene sorta happens in here. The two of them aren't together. It's kind of misleading. So we start out with the Joker telling some random bartender some of his plans, and he's up to something nefarious, obviously. Meanwhile, Batman's trying to track down Deathstroke and stop him. He's still got his problems from last issue to deal with, and apparently everybody knows Batman's secret identity. Even though in the Deathstroke versus Batman issues over in the Deathstroke book, that didn't seem to be the case. He seemed to think that Batman was funded by Bruce Wayne. Here it alludes to the fact that Deathstroke knows. Meanwhile, Harley Quinn and Catwoman have to deal with some Jokerized GCPD. I don't really know if they're Jokerized so much as they're frothing at the mouth like the guy from the Tartarus house from last issue. So I think that's a little misleading too. They don't really look Jokerized. Maybe they are, I don't know. Just looks weird. But a large portion of the book is about Batman fighting with Deathstroke. There's some pointless drama crap between the two of them. Batman pleading to Deathstroke's good nature to let him rebuild Gotham, which is dumb. Deathstroke's a contract killer. He doesn't give a crap about fixing the city. He's in it for himself. The designer is stepping up his plans, and we've got a cliffhanger for next issue. Overall, it was a pretty well-written issue. I just disagree with some of the characterization of Batman talking to Deathstroke like that. Seemed a little whiny to me, and a little unlike Batman. He could have just offered to pay him more, I guess. So I don't know. I think the issue was only okay. It really felt like a lot of filler. The part with the Joker was pretty good, but it's misleading because they start with that, and then you don't see the Joker the rest of the issue. So as far as a part 6 of the storyline goes, it felt like filler, and I was a little disappointed. I don't really like Harley Quinn as a hero anyway. She doesn't really seem the type. I wasn't spectacularly thrilled to have her in here, but the characterization was good. Overall, I think it was just kind of an average issue that felt like padding for the trade paperback. So I would say this one wasn't particularly good, but it wasn't bad either. It was just kind of middle of the road, and it felt very forced and contrived, but it wasn't a bad issue. It just didn't really fit with the overall advancement of the plot. So I would say this is a pretty easily missed issue, and you're not gonna lose a whole lot. There's a little bit of the Catwoman dialogue that might come in to play later, but overall I wasn't impressed. It just felt like a filler issue. So I'd say this one you could probably just skip, but that's just my opinion. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman issue 92. This is from the 2016 Rebirth line from DC Comics, and this is part 7 of their Dark Designs, written by James Tynion IV with Guillaume March as the artist, Tomu Mori was the colorist, Clayton Cowles letters, Yasmin Purdy with Tony Daniels did the cover. The cover's actually really cool. I like that a lot. Dave Walgos was the associate editor, Ben Abernathy editor. While Batman was fighting with Deathstroke last issue, that has to get resolved very quickly because Edward Nygma, aka the Riddler, has got a very cunning plan for Gotham, and he's turning the whole city into a crossword puzzle. And Batman, without the help of communications, has to guess all the correct answers. Meanwhile, Harley Quinn and Catwoman are trying to go to a secret location. Batman has a bat train, by the way, and he solves a lot of Riddler's puzzles and has to track down the Riddler. Meanwhile, Harley Quinn meets Punchline for the first time. time, and they do not get along right away. That was a pretty interesting conversation. And Catwoman is trying to deal with somebody called the Underbroker, who apparently moves criminal money around. This was a really solid issue. It actually is a vast improvement over last issue, not only in story, but the art is really good in here as well. The art's been really solid in these books, but it's really good here. I'm not familiar with Gillum March's work offhand, but it was really solid. I like the way he draws Batman. I don't particularly care for the way he draws Riddler's face, but everybody else looked really good. I like the banter between Batman and Deathstroke. That was funny. And I don't know why Deathstroke ever goes to Gotham. The whole concept was fun. I thought it was probably one of the better issues in the last 5 or 6 issues of this series, and it's definitely moving the story along quite nicely. Finally, last issue was a little fluffy. This one, however, really got to the point and started moving things much, much faster. So I'm really interested to see where next issue goes, because I think it is actually getting better finally after a few weak issues. But this is definitely an issue that you could probably read by itself and enjoy without having to know too much of the meta story, but it would help to know that, obviously. But this one, I think you could get by and enjoy it without that. You'll just be a little lost on some of the overarching plot points, but there's still a lot of fun to be had. So a solid issue all around. I'm definitely going to recommend this one. So that being said, that's just my opinion. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman issue 93 from DC Comics. This is the 2016 series from the Rebirth line, written by James Tynion IV, with art by Javier Fernandez and Guillermo March. Tomio Mori and David Barron did the colors, Clayton Cowles letters, Tony Daniel and Tomio Mori did the cover. And I kind of don't like that cover, actually. I generally like Tony Daniel's art, but that cover's kind of boring. And he looks like Marilyn Manson more than anything else. So Batman is facing off with the designer, going over each of the plans one by one that were developed years ago and how they would have been executed at that time. Then Batman and the designer have a sword fight, while Catwoman transfers all of Wayne's money from all the front companies and offshore accounts to her accounts. And Punchline and Harley are going at each other pretty ruthlessly, and it's not going well for the good guys in this one. The sword fight is pretty cool with the designer, but the twist with that is a bit weird and not really explained very well, in my opinion, how that happens. I kind of get that there's these like zombified Joker people going around. I can buy that one okay, but this twist needs a little more explanation. But the Joker reveals part of his cunning plan, and Batman gets a real serious injury. This was a really solid issue. It really did up the ante quite a bit. I'm absolutely going to recommend this issue. I thought the art was overall very, very good. There's a few panels I didn't care for, but that's all right. The art looks really good. The colors are very vibrant, works very well, and I thought the story here was actually really good. All around a solid issue. I'm definitely going to recommend this one. Quite likely you'll need to pick up the other issues, at least most of them, for this series to make any sense, but this issue definitely had a lot of action. I think if you're just looking for a quick read with some action, you could get something out of this. You're just not going to get the whole meta plot, and you're going to miss a lot of really important information. So while I will recommend this, it is with the hesitation that you would probably need to have read at least the majority of the other issues in this overall story arc to really get the most out of it. But it was a great issue. I was really impressed with it. It's one of the better Batman stories being told, and I was actually pretty impressed. It's almost as good as Batman's Grave, but I kind of like that one just a bit better because that's consistently solid. This has had a few misses, but a good issue, and I would definitely recommend it. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Teespring, and Streamlabs are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Batman issue 94. This is from the 2016 Rebirth line from DC Comics, written by James Tynion IV, art by Guillaume March and Raphael Albuquerque. David Barron did the colors, Clayton Cowles letters, Tony S. Daniel and Tomi Mori did the cover. Dave Wilgo's associate editor, Ben Abernathy editor. Cover's good, but it really doesn't tell you what's going on in the book, and that scene does not happen. So we get a little flashback of Batman trying to find somebody to train him early on in his career, and it turned out to be some amazing detective that he wanted to have him show him the ropes, but the guy kind of blew him off. And then we cut forward and it's an allegory for what's going on with Batman now, and Batman has Deathstroke's sword through his leg when Lucius shows up to help him. And Lucius is kind of a wimp in this, which is really annoying. I don't know why he has cornrows. I find that weird. He's a little too old for that. Anyway, Batman's in some trouble and he knows Selina's in trouble. He wants to go to the hospital to try and rescue her, even though she's been checked in under a pseudonym. He wants to get her over to Leslie Tompkins, but somebody beats him there. And we find out what happened with Deathstroke, Cheshire, and a few of the others. It's kind of tangentially covered, but at least that's resolved. What happens, though, is that Catwoman has been taken by another one of his rogues gallery, and some of Joker's henchmen show up, and Joker rubs it in his face that not only does he know who Batman is, he's got all his money, and he's set him up really, really well. This was a really solid issue. I really enjoyed it. Tynion's doing a great job on this run, and I'm looking forward to reading Joker War. I'm not sure how they're going to wrap it up, but it might tie into Three Jokers. I'm not sure, but I'm looking forward to finding out, so no spoilers. So I'm going to recommend this issue. I thought the art was good, the coloring was really good, and the story was fun. So all around, a solid book. I will definitely recommend this. There's not a lot to this issue because it does tie into previous issues, but you can get kind of an idea of what's going on. It's very much middle story, so there's not a whole lot of action, but it was a pretty solid read. So I'm looking forward to reading the next issue. Until then, this is a solid recommendation. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.